This plugin will be used later in the video, so you can install it if you want. Everything will be linked in the description. This is a new feature and it's basically one step for new 3D layered clothing. It allows you to deform your meshes and it's a really nice addition. Most of these stuff are related to modeling, so I'll leave that part out for modelers out there. I'll link this to description if you want to read it yourself. How it basically works is, there needs to be two meshes with one of them having a wrap target instance and other one having wrap layer. These names are pretty self-explanative, they get rigged differently, and wrap layer gets wrapped to wrap target. There can be multiple wrap layers on wrap target, and the order property manages which one will be applied first. I'll show some examples of what they look like. First example is about applying these wraps to meshes. But first, you need to enable the beta feature for mesh deformation. Go to File, and then Beta Features. Tick the tick box near Cage Mesh Deformer. Click Save when you are done. Mine is already enabled, so I will click Cancel. If we take a look at Explorer View, we can see what these models have. Each model has a mesh inside them. Cube has a wrap layer instance, so that means this cube's appearance will be applied to other mesh. And of course, target has a wrap target instance. These also have some properties that Developer Forum article didn't mention, so hopefully they'll add them soon. Now we can apply this cube to deformed mesh. I'll use the plugin article had. If you want to use this for custom deformed meshes, they have to be in a model. Select the target first, and then select the layer. This order seems to be important for applying, because it currently doesn't work other way around. Here it is, it's now applied to deformed mesh. We have better examples here. These really explain how deformed meshes will change a lot of stuff. These also work with PBR textures if you wonder. I'll speed this part up, so you can take a look at each example here. Meanwhile, I can talk about scripting of these. Meshes don't have a lot to script with, and this is not an exception. You can change wrap layer IDs for textures, or you can change wrap target for updating a mesh with keeping the texture or wrap mesh. This can be useful for realistic car games, where car will get deformed once it crashes. There is one more thing to show, and that's with 3D layered clothing. How these work is as you expected. Body parts have a wrap target instance inside them, and clothing has a wrap layer instance. As far as I can see, new clothing will be able to have PBR textures, which is really exciting. Here is what an accessory looks like. One thing I wonder is, we can't see the old shirt and pants instances. Will 3D layered clothing show up as an attachment instance? I expect a change here. This is in very early beta, so there are some bugs. For example, if you move a body part of these characters, it completely breaks the entire clothing. In addition to that, you can't animate these characters right now. I hope they will make it compatible with R6 and R15 too. I wouldn't want to see these in games, because it just doesn't look good, as you can tell. Everything in this video is in beta, so they are subject to change. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.